Got me like, yeah. When I think about you, that's the first thing that come to
Let
my mind.
Let me do it, JD.
I'm like,
baby,
you can get it out. You can get it out.
Welcome to Hair Reality by Mercedes. I'm Mercedes.
Martini.
Maserati.
This is the show where hair meets reality. So, this is our first show, and this is a show that we've been thinking about doing. So, I'm very, very excited. We're going to be doing this weekly. And we're just, this is my oldest daughter and this is my other daughter, and we're just going to be coming to you guys weekly on our views on hair, reality, music, movies, fashion, and we're just going to bring it to you our style. So, we're going to start the show off today by first saying thank you to all my clients that have made me who I am, and I really appreciate you guys. Okay, so daily I receive emails of questions in reference to hair tips and what should I do to my hair and da 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 da. So I decided to address these emails. So one of the first questions is, my scalp is dry, should I grease it daily? Well, personally, I think that if your scalp is dry, it starts off with the products you use in your hair. Starting off with your shampoo and your conditioners. And if you get a shampoo and conditioner that is for dry scalp, those are is the first priority to making your hair healthy. Greasing your scalp, that was old time, folks. That was back in the day when your mama put you in between the legs and grease your scalp. Well, now, I don't think it's good to just clog your pores up with a lot of grease. So I think you should start off with a nice shampoo and conditioning and some lightweight hair products. Because every time you put the heavy products in, it just clogs your hair and it doesn't allow it to air out. So I personally don't think it's a good choice to grease your hair daily. Number two. Can I have permanent hair color and a relaxer at the same time? Well, you're asking for damage. Those are both chemicals. Permanent hair color and a relaxer, or relaxer has sodium hydroxide, which is a very strong chemical. And if you put those two together, you're asking for a train wreck. Therefore, I recommend if you want hair color, get hair color and press your hair. Flat iron your hair, ceramic flat iron your hair. If you want straight hair without having to press your hair so much, we'll get a relaxer and do not use color. You can get some fusion extensions or maybe some highlights of track, wefted clip-in extensions. Well, no extensions is good for you, but you can get different things that can take the color to a whole nother level without having to damage your hair. If I was you, I'll stick to one or the other. Putting two together, you're asking for damage. Three. Is getting my ends clipped necessary and getting them clipped on a regular basis? Well, of course it's necessary, because if you don't get your ends clipped, you're thinking, oh, you know, I go to the hairstylist and she's going to cut all my hair off. Well, I'm a little different. I like to cut my clients' hair in stages. I don't like to give them a state of shock. So I just take maybe an inch or two, not even that, at each stage. And maybe every 4 weeks I'll tell my client that they need to come back and get their ends clipped, so it won't be a state of shock. But yes, you need to clip your ends regularly, because if you don't, they're going to continue splitting. Before you know it, they're going to be all the way up to the root and they're going to split up. So cutting them allows the splitting to cease or slows it down. So yes, you should get your ends cut on a regular basis. My clients, I like to cut them usually when I offer chemical services. And if you're wearing your hair natural, I like to do it every 4 to 6 weeks. I am completely bald. I have been diagnosed with cancer. Which extension method do you recommend? Well, first of all, I like to tell ladies out there who's stressed out about their hair. First of all, as long as they keep making hair, there's no reason for you to be stressed out. Cancer is hard to deal with within itself. So to worry about your hair troubles, let there be no hair troubles. They have lace units. They have so many extension services. But I recommend a lace unit. A lace unit on someone that has, I call it a complete empty canvas, a blank canvas, which is your hair is completely bald, it makes the unit look that much more real. So I recommend a lace unit, a full lace unit, frontal lace unit, but a lace unit, I think you will be looking just as fly as you was before you were diagnosed with cancer. So don't let cancer, your hair troubles and your dealing with cancer and any other alopecia or thinning of the hair, don't let those trouble you and get you all stressed out. We ladies like to get stressed out about hair, but I say, as long as they keep making human hair, honey, that's the last thing that we need to do is get stressed out about hair. But my recommendation is lace unit. whatever city you're in, you can kind of look into that city. I ship them worldwide, but you have to find somebody to install them. If you're in the Las Vegas or Michigan area, I can recommend you somebody. I'm working on now trying to get other hairstylists from different areas to put on my website so every area can have somebody that can install lace units. But ladies, lace units is the deal. Don't get stressed out. My last one for today is, I have a 10-year-old daughter who wants highlights. What do you think I should do? I think you should tell her to go take a nap. Highlights is a chemical. She's 10 years old. She don't need to even be stressing herself about highlighting her hair. That's for adults. Parents out there under 14, 15 years old who tend to get their kids' hair highlighted, to me, it's teaching them early in advance that you should just damage your hair. It's something that's very damaging to your hair, and it actually, for kids, it makes them look even older than what they are. So I don't recommend highlights. I think you should tell your daughter to go play with her Barbie doll at 10. So tell her no, she cannot have highlights. If she came into my salon, I will not do highlights. If anybody knows Marcedes, money is not what makes my salon. What makes my salon is my clients. And my first and foremost concern is the healthiness of their hair. So when they ask for things that just doesn't make any sense to me personally, and I'm a professional, I totally go against it. For kids at 10 years old with highlights, I most definitely won't even offer that service. It just won't happen in my salon. So I suggest that you just let her be 10 at 10 and stay 10. All right, so we're going to get into the rest of the show where I say hair meets reality. And this is going to be Martini's view, this is going to be Maserati's view, this is going to be my view, and this is going to be our view on hair and fashion and movies and music. So I'm just going to start it off by, we're going to go over some hair things. And we're going to talk about, in the last couple weeks, some hair do's and don'ts. And my first person this week is going to be talking about Christina Milian's hair. When I first seen her hair, it just shocked me. You know, when we first get a new color, it just takes us four spins, so we get shocked. Yes, we do. When I first seen her hair wasn't as bad as maybe the red lipstick she had on and maybe the old school glasses. I don't know where she got those glasses from, the dollar store, but I think that made her hair look even that much more worse. There's been so many blogs and comments on what she done to her hair. Well, actually, when I seen more pictures of her hair without the glasses and without the prostitute red lipstick, I actually like her hair. It becomes her. She's got fair, pretty skin, and she's got beautiful hair. So, Christina, do what you do, but honey, leave the red lipstick and the glasses alone. Alright, Sierra. I just seen Sierra. I love Sierra, and I just seen her rocking some old school, what was that, set it off, Queen Latifah braids. But she was looking good. She had them going straight to the back, and that, you know, we ain't done that in years, but it just tells you that you can bring whatever you've done before, you can bring it back. And Sierra, I really loved your braids. They looked really nice on you, and it shows everybody in the world that you're not bald-headed, that you actually have hair and you have edges, although you wear extensions and weaves and lace units or whatever. So I'm glad to see you rocking your hair, and you look good in it. Amber Rose. Do we know who Amber Rose is?
Kanye's girlfriend.
Kanye's girlfriend. Well, you know what? Once again, there's a lot of blogs out there, and they hating on my girl Amber. I think she is absolutely gorgeous. I think anybody who can shave their hair off and wear it in a low-cut men's style, I give her all praise and ups, and I wish I could do it. I don't think I look good without hair, so I give you all ups. Everybody can't do it, and she can, so quit hating on her.
New York City, you are now rapping with 50 Cent. You gotta love it.
I just wanna chill and twist the lock, catch stunts in my 745. You drive me crazy, shorty, I need to see you and feel you next to me. I provide everything you need, and I like your smile, I don't wanna see you cry. Got some questions that I gotta ask, and I hope you can come up with the answers, baby.
Girl, it's easy to love me now, would you love me if I was down and out? Would you still have love for me, girl?